Have you ever tried to spike the ball in volleyball or swing a golf club? It's hard at first, but the more you practice, the better you'll get. Professional athletes spend a lot of time practicing, but sometimes adding a little bit of science can really help them out. USC professor Jill McNitt-Gray uses physics to help athletes to be their best. She studies the biomechanics of movements to find the body positions that lead to quick turns and high jumps.
When we talk about biomechanics of movement, we're really trying to figure out what are the forces involved in causing the movement that you see.
There are internal forces, like those caused by muscles contracting and pulling on bones. And there are external forces, like those between our bodies and the ground. When we push on the ground, it pushes back on us. This is called the reaction force, and it plays a role in causing motion. And because we live on Earth, we also experience the force of gravity, which we know as body weight.
In biomechanics, we study all of that. We understand how muscles are coordinated to generate reaction forces at the ground, and we also understand how we have to overcome the effects of gravity. Biomechanics is all around you, and part of it is just watching people move and try to take on challenges, and it could be everyday tasks, or it could be, lead athletes doing long jump.
Jill works with such athletes to improve their performance. She films them at practice and then analyzes the video frame by frame to understand how the athletes are interacting with the ground and generating motion. At USC, the gym also has force plates, which allow Jill to measure the forces from the ground.
When your feet touch the ground and they push, we get a force acting on them, and we're able to use the force plate information to actually visualize what those forces are. So as they push on the ground, we can see those forces acting on their body. And sometimes if they're trying to jump high, for example, we want to have a lot of area underneath that vertical force time curve, and it'll be like a hump. But if you can get the area under that curve to be even bigger, that means they're able to convert from zero velocity to a bigger vertical velocity. More vertical velocity, more time in the air, and the higher they jump.
Velocity describes how fast an object is moving in a specific direction. If you want a long air time when you jump, you need to have a large vertical velocity, created by pushing off the ground with a strong upward force.
If you only get a little bit of vertical, it will just be a little bit of time in the air. But if you get a lot of vertical, you have a lot of time in the air. And that lets an athlete do a lot of things. They can get in position to block, they can do a jump shot, they can go above their defender to make the shot, those kind of things. And so we really look to figure out ways that they can generate more force on the ground, even if it's a short period of time, so they can get that vertical velocity at takeoff.
By changing how the athletes use their leg muscles to push off the ground, they can make greater forces and higher jumps.
In the gym, what's really cool is because we have force plates in the gym, we can actually show them what those force time curves look like, and they can go back and try again. So if they want to make it bigger, they can experiment a little bit and see, if I push this way or that way, or if I'm in a different body position, what works for me to get that vertical velocity? And that's very cool, because then they learn about their own body, they also learn about physics, and they try to figure out how the two things can work together to get their performance better.
Motions have many parts, and part of what Jill does involves breaking down each movement for analysis using 3D computer models. These models let her study how athletes like volleyball players have to move horizontally to get into position before moving vertically to jump and block a shot. The key part is the transition from horizontal to vertical motion, or making your body stop moving side to side and start moving up.
Say volleyball players, this is really important. If they're going to block a ball over the net, they need to get up first so that they can create that ceiling and make it hard for that hitter to get the ball over the net. So getting a good vertical jump is really important. Now they're not just standing by the net. Oftentimes they have to move to where the hitter is going to be and then do the jump. So we have to work on working with their horizontal speed and their conversion to vertical to make that happen.
Jill talks about how she was always passionate about sports and how she takes this passion as inspiration for a deep understanding of the physics behind our movements.
When you're doing athletics, it's almost like you're practicing physics on a daily basis to try to improve performance and try to figure out what is it I can do or what is it I can do to help my teammate perform better on the field. You don't really realize it to start with, but as you experiment and get better and with good coaching, you can kind of figure out how things work. And so I think by being an athlete, you get to kind of test things out, the laws of physics for real, with your own body. And it's very, very cool because you kind of, every day you go to practice and you try something new and you're pretty systematic and you can kind of figure out, oh, that's how that works. And then you're successful at doing it. That makes it all more fun.
Want to learn more about how physics can help your sports performance? Visit the Curiosity Machine.